It's Venture's Super Sale, now through Saturday. Save on these household chemicals, just 88 cents. Coke is just $5.88 for a 24-can case. Cotton Terry Counterpoint Towels, now $1.88. Sunsation's 1-inch vinyl mini blinds are $6.88 for all sizes. Canon SureShot 35mm camera is sale priced at $123.88. And Daytron's VCR with wireless remote is only $189.88. So get to Venture by Saturday before the super savings disappear.
What a year for Nissan. First we topped the quality ratings, now we want to top every year-end sale in town. Because the 88s are on their way, and Nissan's putting up millions to move every 87 in stock. So forget sticker prices, forget standard financing. It's the best time for the best deals on the best-built Japanese cars of all. Nissan.
We're your hometown Nissan dealers, made for Chicago.
Channel 2, WBBM Television, Chicago.
From Chicago's news team. Live. The 10 o'clock news.
When we think of vacations, we think of relaxing, someplace new, visiting someplace warm. But tonight, hundreds of travelers are finding out they may have been left out in the cold. Good evening. The Cook County State's Attorney is now investigating Carefree Vacations, a travel company that suddenly closed its doors this afternoon. As Susan Wallace reports, hundreds of people who were planning to go on vacation now may be going nowhere.
The office of Carefree Vacations showed no signs of life this evening, and only a telephone recording told the tale.
Carefree Vacations has ceased operations on all flights effective 1:30 p.m. September 25th.
With hundreds of clients about to depart for Mexico, Las Vegas, and Florida, many of them already there, the company mysteriously packed up. Its money supply apparently dried up. And neither the state's attorney nor the attorney general's office was entirely surprised by the Carefree shutdown. Both offices have recently received numerous complaints about the low-budget Carefree travel packages. So, too, have travel agents.
Say the last year or so, we haven't used them nearly as much because there were a number of problems in terms of the overall program and client dissatisfaction.
Can you specify?
Well, one of the most frequent situations that has come up was the client getting the hotel in Las Vegas and there not being room for them at the hotel, being walked, we call in the industry.
And this isn't the first time Carefree clients have been stranded.
The plane hasn't been here.
Hey, get the damn luggage.
3.5 years ago, angry flyers stormed the Carefree counter because they were forced to sit in airports waiting for planes that were delayed a half day or more. Leo Sharp, the owner of Carefree Vacations, has been in business for 15 to 20 years, which does not suggest he is a fly-by-night operator. One travel agent says he just hit hard times and an empty wallet and will probably eventually get back on his feet and have his clients back on their way. There is help for some Carefree clients who are already out of town. A plane load is set to land in Chicago about an hour and a half from now. Apparently, the company that leases planes to Carefree, a Tennessee airline, agreed to pick up those clients despite the fact that Carefree has not paid its fuel bills and is not paying for this flight.
Susan, there is a rather bizarre story breaking at this hour in Washington, D.C., involving a deathbed confession that seems to shed some new light on that whole Iran-Contra affair. The former CIA director, William Casey, in a deathbed confession to reporter Bob Woodward, admitted that he knew all about the diversion of funds to the Contras from the very beginning of the operation. Now, before Casey died, back in May of this year, you may recall, he claimed publicly to have known nothing of the scandal, at that point contradicting key portions of Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North's story. And in the Persian Gulf tonight, a ship from Iran, which was caught laying mines earlier this week, has been blown up by the U.S. Navy. The Iranian crew from that ship is now heading for Oman and home aboard the ship, this one, being escorted by warships from the U.S. Navy and attack helicopters. Secretary of Defense Caspar Weinberger is on a mission to the Gulf right now. Earlier, he watched Navy divers at work blowing up a suspected mine.
I want you to know how proud the American people are, particularly the president. He specifically asked me to give you his best regards, but more than that, his very great appreciation for all that you're doing.
Weinberger says the Navy will continue to seek out and attack any mine-laying ships in the Persian Gulf.
Missouri police say they may never know why a 14-year-old boy went on a shooting rampage today and murdered his entire family. Armed with a Saturday night special, 14-year-old Kirk Butler shot his mother and father, his three brothers, the youngest was 15 months old, and then his aunt. Kirk himself was finally killed in a scuffle with his uncle. Neighbors don't understand it. They do say the family was poor and worked very hard. Another tragedy, this one closer to home in Batavia. The whole town grieving tonight for three young men killed in a car crash, an accident involving alcohol. Michael Jeske, Sean Osland, a high school football player, and John Lekancic, all 17, died after their car smashed into a tree. Police say all were legally drunk.
Came home from practice, had dinner, left the house about 8:30, quarter to 9. And waited up for him until 12:30, and I thought, you know, where is he? Why isn't he home?
They all liked him. I know they did. He was a clown. What can they say? He's gone.
Batavia High School is offering crisis support counseling to the boys' classmates.
It is day and now night number 14 of the teacher strike in Chicago, and both sides are back at this moment at the bargaining table. Teachers picketing outside the board today got some help from parents who then went inside to talk things out with both sides. More than 100 parents waited patiently until they got a chance to tell both the union and the board to please get their children back in school. Tonight, the two sides are still, as I say, bargaining at the table.
The Reverend Jerry Falwell is blaming Jim Baker for Jessica Hahn's Playboy poses tonight, and Falwell says he believes Baker will soon be indicted by the federal government. The charges came during a speech Falwell made downtown in Chicago today. Falwell told a group of executives that Hahn posed nude in Playboy because she was changed after having sex with Baker in a Tampa hotel 7 years ago. Falwell also said he believed Jim Baker will be indicted.
I think he will be indicted.
For what?
I think wire fraud, mail fraud, and a lot of other issues that clearly the government cannot turn its head on.
Reverend Falwell says he plans to step down as PTL chairman in January.
And don't go away, because soon we will be hearing Tammy Baker sing her new hit. Or a new record. She wants to be a hit.
And here's a surprise. A new television ad starring Gregory Peck leaves President Reagan a little hot under the collar. And Pope John Paul II leaves American Catholics with a hefty bill to be paid.
I'm Alcott.
I'm Andrews.
The outstanding woman in the corporate world doesn't wear a uniform. She needs an elegant, versatile, beautifully made wardrobe that suits her personal style.
But she's too busy running from meeting to meeting, so she can't be running from store to store. She needs one store where she can get the quality of clothing she wants.
And the personal service she needs at prices that don't insult her intelligence. Isn't it great?
Alcott and Andrews, 430 North Michigan Avenue.
Your Ford dealer has it. 1.9% financing, Ford's lowest rate ever. But that's not all. We have something nobody else can give you. The best-built American cars and trucks for 7 years running. So it's no accident we have the number one selling cars and trucks in America. Your Ford dealer has the winning lineup. 1-9 or cash back, the best-built and the best-selling cars and trucks, and option packages to save you up to $1,800 more. Where? Your local Ford dealer. Quality people, quality products.
Now you can get a home-style dinner. No matter where you roam, 'cause as long as there's a Bob Evans, you're just a few smiles
Hi.
From home.
Welcome to Bob Evans.
You'll like our charbroiled chicken and ribs, the halibut and steak, our grated snow field. Welcome to Bob Evans.
Some of the best cooking you'll ever have.
Just a few smiles from home.
There is a new twist to report tonight in the battle over the Supreme Court nomination of Judge Robert Bork. The actor from Hollywood, Gregory Peck, well, he's made a television commercial hitting Bork. Peck says Bork is bad for America. President Reagan says Peck is wrong.
This is Gregory Peck. Robert Bork wants to be a Supreme Court justice, but the record shows that he has a strange idea of what justice is. He defended poll taxes and literacy tests, which kept many Americans from voting.
Mr. President, what do you think about Gregory Peck beating up on Bork?
Newscast. Reagan says that Peck has no basis for making the ad and no business whatever telling Americans what to think.
Well, the party's over and the honored guest has gone home, but there's the matter of the check. Who's going to get stuck with it? In many of the cities where Pope John Paul II visited last week, the parishioners will be watching a second collection passing their way.
San Francisco seems to be pressed the hardest. The city where Pope John Paul II reached out to comfort AIDS patients and homosexuals, but did not condone their lifestyle. He left $1 million tab yet to be raised. Archbishop John Quinn has asked parishes to take up a special collection, which should help pay the remainder of the $3.3 million bill. In Columbia, South Carolina, a five-hour visit cost $500,000, with about $150,000 left to be paid. The church is mailing a plea for money to donors suggested by local priests. Some money has come from television viewers around the country, and in San Antonio, Texas, church officials think they will actually have some money left over, spending only about $2 million of their $2.5 million budget. In Monterey, California, the Pope stayed just a few hours, and two-thirds of the $2 million budget was raised before the visit. One way the archdiocesan offices are raising money is by selling video cassettes of the visit. I asked Bishop Timothy Lyon of Holy Name if the Pope's trip is worth the money.
Well, we think it's very worth it because, first of all, his presence. Secondly, it causes a nation to focus on how it lives and how it acts. And I think it forces individual Catholics to take a good look at their lives and ask the question of whether or not they really are in conformity with the gospel of Christ. I think that's the important thing.
Think it will help with the recruiting of priests?
Well, I hope so. But I think we'll always get priests just because there will always be idealistic young people who try to and want to serve the Lord.
But then, what price could you put on receiving Mass from the Pope?
After a break, Harold will be along with a forecast for the weekend, and it's not as though we want to keep you here or anything, but if you wait around a few minutes, you'll see Tammy Baker sing a new song.
No one ever called me a mama's boy. But when you're stationed out in Germany, 15 months till you go home, and you're getting up every morning in the pitch dark and running yourself ragged till it gets dark again, well, you don't have to be a mama's boy. You just love the sound of your mama's voice.
Only AT&T keeps you this close anywhere in the world. AT&T International Long Distance.
Why are listeners choosing WCLR 102 FM, Chicago's Light Rock?
WCLR mixes my favorite songs from the 60s, the 70s, and today.
WCLR plays light rock with less talk, like the Supremes,
Chicago, Billy Joel.
WCLR, light rock.
Less talk and more music.
WCLR, livelier than Lake, but not hard like Top 40.
WCLR, 102 FM, Chicago's light rock with less talk.
I'm Linda McLennan. Monday on First Edition, Democratic presidential contender Paul Simon.
Plus, when we last saw Bob Wallace, he was wrapped up in the world's biggest bubble. Monday, we'll find out where he'll pop up next. I'm Lester Holt. Those stories and more.
Monday at 4:30 on First Edition.
The marble columns could have come from the baths of Caracalla outside Rome. The art on the walls could have come from the Museum of Modern Art in New York. And the chef could have come from the Brasserie Gisonde in Lyon. But a five-year performance record that looks like this could only have come from one business bank in Chicago, the Exchange National Bank.
Marshall Field's Housewares Fair, recipes for the good life. From Oster, the kitchen center, five appliances in one, just $149.99. The Bioneer BT200 humidifier, a tasty 30% off. Magnolite's professional 16-piece cookware set, just $299.99. From Krupp's, the 10-cup brewmaster, a delicious 30% savings. And now through October 3rd, with every Housewares purchase, receive this canvas tote, yours for just $7.50. Marshall Field's Housewares Fair, special savings through October 3rd.
Hurricane Emily is the name. Forecasters have an eye on her tonight. After losing strength earlier this week, she came back with a vengeance, slamming into Bermuda with winds of 80 miles an hour. The storm flipped cars, tore roofs from buildings. So far, 16 people have been hurt there.
And here, beautiful tomorrow, right?
Gorgeous. Whenever there's a hurricane out there, it's usually beautiful here. That's the way that works.
Oh, that's true.
Yes, it's peaceful in one place and calm in another. Let's take a look quickly at what temperatures are tonight in Chicago on this Friday evening. Just 3 months away from Christmas. We have 51 at O'Hare now, Lakefront 61, Midway 56. The low this morning, 44. Not anything like the 30 we had in 1942, which was Chicago's earliest freeze. 45 years ago this morning, it was 30. Humidity's 80%, the wind southwest 6, and the city's beautiful tonight. With the pressure rising, you feel pretty good. You've got a day tomorrow that's going to be sunny because there are no clouds on this satellite view tonight, as you see. Emily's clouds are racing 45 miles an hour over the shipping lanes in North Atlantic. That's moving very rapidly. Scattered thunderstorms in the Rockies and in South Florida. Miami was soaked with an inch and a half of rain tonight. The temperature climbed to 92 at the airport. Thunderstorms still flash around. Our bright, sunny high is continuing here. It will drift eastward. Let's see where it goes to tomorrow as we jump to the Saturday afternoon map. The high moves off the east coast, allowing a southerly flow to move in with 20-mile-an-hour wind gusts. This front will hold off till Monday, so we'll get a beautiful Sunday, and then some showers come through Monday, then it clears up for Tuesday and Wednesday. Highs will be in the 70s tomorrow, but the 80s will move in for Sunday. So let's look at it now as it's set up by Diane on the Vidifont. Clear and very cool, low 60 near the lake to 45 well inland, light winds. For tomorrow, sunshine, windy, warmer, high 77, south to southwest winds 10 to 20. Sunday will be sunny and warm with a high near 80. Monday, there are those showers in there with about 75 degrees. Tuesday and Wednesday, 68. Beautiful days as we wind up September already, Bill.
Thank you, Harry. Governor Thompson is on his way to Europe tonight, leaving from O'Hare with his wife and an entourage of about 21 people, paid for by the Aspen Institute, a group that promotes economic ties between the U.S. and West Germany. $120,000 of the cost of the trip will be covered by the state of Illinois. The governor says he will be building up business for Illinois and that when he went to Japan recently, he brought back a $600 million auto assembly plant for the state. Thompson says it is critical for Illinois that he do business abroad and that he will be gone about 14 days, all of which is the subject of Walter's perspective.
That'll be just long enough, won't it? And in Germany, the governor will be far enough to avoid the most critical business that he has here at home. Now, I don't mean to sound like a broken record, but Governor Thompson is acting like a broken record, and somebody ought to sound like it. A crisis at home, he goes away. A crisis at home, he goes away. As far away as he can possibly get, off to that terminal, international at O'Hare, 5,000 miles to West Berlin. He'll even be hard to reach by telephone. He and his wife and their friends and their colleagues in search of some business for their great state of Illinois, while their god-awful schools are closed, 14 days that almost 500,000 children have been locked out. More than 25,000 teachers in picket lines on the streets, and the mayor and the governor doing not a damn thing about it. The one of them's at a fashion show playing, or he's in his office hiding. And the other one is off to Berlin running. A crisis at home, he goes away. A crisis at home, he goes away. It was to Washington that he went away on Wednesday doing a favor for President Reagan, a speech on television to support Robert Bork. And on Thursday, the next day, the governor, with a crisis in the schools, was making a speech for the Republican Party, a flourish of words about a politician on the south side of Chicago, switching his allegiance from Democrat to Republican. The governor hurried home from Bork with words of praise for Sam Paniadovich, but not a word of anything all day long for the teachers or the Board of Education. It is the Governor Thompson broken record. Crisis at home, he goes away. Well, for all the good that he does at home, Governor Thompson ought to stay away.
DuPont Stainmaster, only at Olson.
Buy 1 yard, get one free.
Enso 5 worry-free, only at Olson.
Buy 1 yard. Get one free.
Monsanto Stain Blocker, only at Olson.
Buy 1 yard, get one free. Beautiful stain-resistant carpet. Buy 1 yard, get one free. Only at Olson.
During Eagle's biggest sale ever, we're really stocking up on hundreds of national brands. Because we know people will be in a hurry to get there as quickly as they can. If they can.
This week at Eagle Food Stores, stock up and save on Stella Cheeses, only $1.99. Nabisco Premium Saltines, just 79 cents. Save during the Fall Festival of National Brands at Eagle.
Cool street, neat street, Main Street. Kicking back my feet, street, Main Street.
It's Main Street's greatest fleece sale ever. All the fleece you want, all on sale.
Main Street is your street.
For 1 week only, save big on every piece of fleece. From the latest looks to the brightest basics.
One street, many streets. Saving on my penny street. Main Street is your street.
It's the greatest fleece sale ever. Hurry in.
You don't have to look far to find some high-performance luxury sports coupes with impressive performance. You don't have to look any farther than Mazda's all-new MX-6 GT, a turbocharged, intercooled road machine that'll outrun those guys and run you many, many thousands less.
It's all part of our intense commitment to your total satisfaction. That's the Mazda way.
Get a great deal at your Chicagoland Mazda dealer today.